on that fight, or is there like mandatory issues and things like that?
Well, they better be. that's what this whole thing's about. They need to be. They need to be.
Anthony, usually people are talking about Beterbiev. Nobody's smiling and, you know, kind of jovial. Mm-hmm. And you're just kind of chill, relaxing, you're laughing like crazy. Yeah. Like, what makes you just so confident that, yo, he's going to lose when he goes up against
you?
It's
just my personality. It's just my personality. A lot of people, one thing about me, I don't get nervous. Because for me, it's like, the way I see life is, it's going to be what it's going to be. And when you've, like, experienced some of the things I've experienced in life, I'm not talking about boxing, I'm talking about how I've even come up. It's just like, this is fun in here. This is opportunity. This is how you get opportunity to change your life. There's people doing things in the seat crazier than this, and there's no reward. Do you get what I'm saying? So it's like,
Anthony, a lot of things Anthony going talk a little bit about that, because we here in New York, we in the United States, a lot of people, they don't know England the way you've experienced England. They don't know about East London. They don't know about all of that, the adversity you face, not to mention coming back from losses to Lyndon Arthur and to Kovalev. Talk to us a little bit about that adversity you face.
Adversity is not only in the boxing, but just in life. And again, that's why I feel like I've got a character. I'm able to bounce back. Everyone, the people that do know, I lost 4 family members during COVID. And then again, I fought Lyndon Arthur months later. So again, my mind wasn't there. But at the same time, it shows me within myself, my mental strength, to just come back, understand that life happens, come back, and try and make something for yourself. So I feel like that's enough inspiration for anybody that gives excuses or says, oh, I've got it hard. Try and make something for yourself. You got one life, innit?
I don't want to go into like a game plan or anything like that. Yeah. I hate saying stuff like that. But do you kind of feel that the key to kind of beating Beterbiev is kind of like perpetual movement and not just standing there and banging with him?
I think the key to beating someone like Beterbiev is being a better fighter, being sharper, quicker, more intelligent. And we'll see on fighting that. I feel like I'll shock a lot of people when we fight.
How confident are you that you actually hit better than Beterbiev?
I'm quite confident. I think from what I saw today, he is a heavy hitter. Because some of the shots is like they were just swinging shots over the top, but at the same time, he was catching Smith when he was coming in, throwing shots. And as you've seen in boxing time and time again, the punch down hurts the most, the punch you don't see. So when Smith's throwing punches, and again, let's not forget the fight ended quite early. So Smith, none of them looked like they warmed up properly. To me, they both look slow. I feel like if the fight went on a bit longer, we would have seen more resistance from Joe Smith Jr.
Do you think it should have gone a little bit longer, or you think
Smith was done? No. He was all over the place. Even when the referee called it off, he took like 4 steps backwards. So again, everyone's got a life to live after boxing, and I'm sure I saw Joe Smith Jr. actually walking back to the stage. He's still not got his feet underneath him, so it's about staying safe in the street.
Do you